Trey, what's up, brother? Hey, man, appreciate your support and for your patronage. Let's go ahead and do your account overview. All right, so your pictures, probably the two most important things that you're going to have when you're doing your listing is your first picture and your price. That first picture is good. So you went to a parking lot, looks like, and took some good photos. I'm sure when you took them, it was not this zoomed in. So what happens when you upload them, for whatever reason, Toro's server will crop out a lot of the pictures. So just if able, you can maybe take the same photos and zoom out on them. Or if not, then you might consider going back and taking some photos, just because it's cut off. It's not going to be as good as if you can see the full car. Now, the angle, this is what I use for all my first ones, is this kind of an angle on it from the front quarter to kind of see the whole car. Let's go through the rest of these photos. Again, same thing on this one. The sun, it can be nice, but a lot of times it's a distraction, and you're an all-black car. It's not a big deal, but it can change the color of the car sometimes if you got sun on one side, not on the other. So if you have a day that you can take it where it's not as bright, that's cool. If you can avoid having yourself in there, that's also cool, but not. These are pretty nitpicky things right now. I like this photo here. If you just got it detailed, I would consider doing it again, just because you can see a little bit of stuff here. But this picture looks really cool. Looks like you're in front of a cathedral. That's a great place to take a picture, or maybe a university. But not if you can't see it. So maybe back up. You already mentioned taking all this stuff out. That's kind of a must. The keys. So when you get your keys, you don't want to have anything on it except for the key. I mean, unless this little key fob is for a parking garage or something of that nature, just that key on there. No fancy key rings. Just one simple key ring is all we really have on ours. Toro used to sell some key rings that were okay, but not great, and so we don't like those either. Same comment on this here. I think you already picked up on that. Again, I like the picture. The angle is good, so you can see you're trying to see all the instrument cluster. You just can't in this picture because of the way they zoomed in. Probably same thing on this one as well. So just maybe take the photos a little bit back, or find the right, maybe there's some upload tips that you can check out to better see what's going on here. So one picture I always like to take, and we have on ours, is a picture from the middle back seat looking forward through the seats. I push all these seats back. When I take pictures in the back seat, I push them all the way forward. So if I'm taking a picture of the back seat, I push them forward. If I'm taking a picture of the front seat, I push them back. It makes, you know, it's a little bit deceptive, but you want to show the best side of your car, not the worst. If this folds down and there's a little armrest here, I might pop that down on one of the pictures as well. Six photos is fine. I'd say that's the minimum that you'd want to have on there. But 12 is great. 20 is great. So here's an example of something that's good. So this is his first photo. He took this himself. This is Ryan Labadie. He's one of the, mentors for a lot of the Toro people here. I'm not sure if you've seen him around, but in Indianapolis, I'm not sure if they have the verified photos. Verified photos means that Toro sends somebody out there for free to take professional photos of your car that will guaranteed look nice. So he chose to make this his first picture because it's a little bit closer up view. It's kind of in your face. But this is the one that that Toro would have uploaded for him. You see it's a nice setting. There's nothing distracting there at all. And then just copy what they do. So these verified photos, they do, I think, 12 of them. One from each quarter panel, one from the full-on front, full-on side, and then a few interior shots, one as well as the trunk. And I'm just kind of scroll through these. You can see front corner, back quarter, full-on, side, front. They go to a place that's not really, I mean, it's kind of urban looking and distracting. You can see the difference. These are the professional photos. These are these photos. So even these photos are nice. Normally I would say it was okay. This car is kind of annoying in the background. But you just want the focus to be on your car. Nothing taking away from what you have up there on the car. And you can see again the color is a huge difference when you have that verified photo in there. And then people know that this isn't just some dude on the internet that says he's got a car, that someone's saying that this has been seen and it does exist. Picture of the trunk, you want to get one of those as well. And then you already have one like this. Here's the one from the back seat with the instrument cluster. He has one of him on there so you can kind of see it. And then here's some more that he took. These are the personal ones he got before he got the verified photos. All good photos. Something to think about when you're getting it done. You can see on this one it cropped it in there too close and cut off the badge as well. So just something to think about. Indianapolis, they don't have it in my city. Indy might be bigger, so they might actually have someone there that will come out and take these photos for free. You just got to sign up for it and then wait. Might take months, but if you haven't signed up for that, go ahead and do that now. All right, we'll come down here. A Buick Regal 2017, $39 a day. I think the price is fine for starting out. I would probably up it down the road, depending on what your competition is. You got the touring model. You got most of the options, I would imagine, or maybe all the options. So everything looks good there. Sport touring, I would say, you know, the gas premium, good thing you have it written down there. I'd write it down lower as well. 25 mpg, is that what they automatically put in there? Because you can edit that. Is yours better? Maybe when you drive it, you get 28, and maybe that's what you want to post in there. I wouldn't fudge the truth too much, but you know, make it the best, your best foot forward on that. I really like this write-up. It's maybe a little bit short, but I like how you start off. A fantastic, economical, luxury sports sedan, 2.0-liter, turbocharged engine, 259 horses, upgraded wheels. So that's all good things here on the beginning right here, and then you go into a little bit more detail. That is great. I like that a lot. I'm gonna show you Ryan's, because he's who I kind of looked after when I first started, and you can see he's got the same kind of thing going on at the beginning as well. You don't have 1,300 trips or 5-star reviews. I guess you do have one 5-star review, but something to think about down the road as you build it up. You want to put that in there, and then just copy this. I mean, here is his link up here at the top. I'll just leave that there for you to check out. Actually, what I'll do is I'll message it to you right now. Ryan, someone that I know is good, and who is maybe I shouldn't show you all this nonsense. I don't even know. Message Trey. All right, we'll paste that right there. Boom. All right, now you got it. All right. But he's someone that you want to emulate. He's been doing this for years. He just got his, I think, 60th car, 60 cars that he rents out, and he's got supercars. So definitely someone you want to think about. First of all, he talks about it, talks it up a little bit, gives some just basic ground rules and sets things going on. They were in a blog, and then he does this. I copied this verbatim. I just copied it and pasted straight off of there. First trip with Toro, here's a free $25 credit. So that could be the difference between, hey, here's, you know, get your rental half off. If you've never done rent Toro before, you can use your link to get on there and do that and get that $25 off. He has taxes, so check your taxes, and you can kind of knock some of that stuff out. Now, if you do have taxes, there is a new way in Street Smarts to actually request those taxes and get that stuff taken care of. And I'll probably have to make another video of that another time. But just know that there is a way to take care of taxes and kind of automatically request those as they come up. By continuing to book, he's saying that you're going to pay the sales tax in addition to. Now, as far as extras on yours, whoops, let's go back to here. I don't see any extras yet. This review right here, it's important. The dogs are welcome thing, that's up to you, man. We don't allow dogs, and we don't really recommend that other people do as well. You might be a big dog person, and your dogs might be amazing, but the next ones might not be. And then down the road, it's hard to get that pet hair out completely, or even sometimes that smell. And it could cause allergies for other people. You just service animals you have to allow, but you can still charge for cleaning fees. Up to you if you want to leave that in there. That's kind of your baby. Smoking is not permitted in the car. Perfect. Again, kind of on these guidelines, try to get as specific as you can. There's nothing stopping you from having more guidelines. This is all they have there for their guidelines, because he's going to send out those Street Smarts messages, and it's going to be very detailed with what the rules are, so they kind of don't really worry too much about the details there, or guidelines rather. All right, so this review, I'm gonna give you one, this kind of one-off deal here. If you look at our $50 a month Patreon charge, what you're going to see is like $50, and then it's gonna have a cheat code on it, right? So all we're gonna do is we're gonna rent your car, and then we're gonna review it. So you'll have that first review, you'll have that response rate, you'll have a really great review, just kind of starting you off to get you set up on the right foot. The $50, we're gonna rent your car from you, right? So that money is not really. It's you're gonna get most of that back. Now you're gonna lose a little bit because of Toro's insurance. But you're going to gain that review, and then that's something we can do monthly. So it sounds like a lot of money initially, but honestly, it's not really, because we're renting your car and giving you that review based on what we see. And we don't want to lie about anything, so we're going to be honest, but we're going to kind of coach you through it, make sure it's a good experience for everybody. Excuse me. All right. So that's the first page. All good things. This is a good start here. The pictures are good. If you can get them zoomed out a little bit, I would recommend you do that. Trey here. This is a good photo. It shows that someone else likes you in the world, I guess. It shows that you joined back in 2016. Longevity is a good thing. You have friends. That's cool. You have a job, and you went to school. All good things. Response time, 0 minutes. You want to keep it like that. You want to keep it really, really low. And so if you haven't already signed up for the Street Smarts, go on there. It's free for your first month. Just do it maybe right before you start. And I just posted all of the templates for all of what we say. And we've had a really good response with that. So I'd recommend you use that as well. But maybe hold off until you get it, because it is free the first month. The second month, you pay after the fact. So you're going to have it for 2 months before you pay a dime. And then it's just based on what you use for the car. And if you're renting it more than once a month, it's definitely worth it not to have to deal with everything. And that's going to keep this response rate at 100%. It's also going to keep the response time down. That's what you want. I've been helping some guys out who were just kind of flirting with it initially, and they had a response rates of like 50%. And once you have a response rate below 95%, you get deprioritized in the listing. So the more ratings you have, the more that Toro knows that they can trust you to follow through, then the higher you're gonna show up in the results, and the better it's gonna be for you. Your vehicle is gonna show up here. A general idea of where you're located at is gonna show up here, and then you have that one trip that you took back in the day, and you got a 5-star trip on that. So that's awesome, awesome for that. Excuse me. All right, so. That's kind of the basic review. When you're looking through it, find someone that's got a good one and then look through theirs. Like I said, we copied Ryan's for obvious reason. When you go into his profile here and you can see what kind of what he's sharing, it's going to go a little bit better into depth onto who they are. You're going to see he's got a Facebook page set up. You're going to see his many, many, many vehicles. There's more vehicles. He's got over 1,400 trips now, and he's got a whole range of things. So this is kind of what is out there as you kind of grow this business. It can be as little as one and as many as 60, or there's guys with 100 cars, and you can see that his cars aren't just crap cars. He's got Mercedes and Infinities and Caddies and Vipers. So I think he's got a Maserati. Let's see if it's listed yet. Yep, look at that. Maserati's on there. So he's really taking it and run with it. And so it's someone that you want to look and emulate, someone that we emulate. And he started with Dodge Grand Caravans, Toyota Yaris's. I mean, this is one of his highest renters right here, 74 trips, that Dodge Viper he started out with way back in the day. And so I'll go back to his profile, and you can kind of see, excuse me, email address, all of that stuff on there. He's got the response time of 100%, 2 minutes. 2 minutes is the fastest that you're going to get, I think, once you start getting booked, just based on the time it takes for the internet to refresh and things. So that's kind of the gold standard that you want to be at. You want to get these going right here. Minivan, and you can see it doesn't matter. Once you have your system set up, it doesn't matter if it's a Stingray or if it's a 2005 Grand Caravan. This stuff really makes a difference. When people see that, they know that other people have rented from you. They're going to trust you a lot more when you get that 1,400 trips. That's an amazing mark. So if you have any questions, man, let me know. I can do next month, I can do a look at your market if you like. Let me know what you want that to be. for your next month's review, or it can just be a re-review of this stuff. And if you're interested in that $50 tier, we'll rent your car from you. You'll get paid money back, and then you'll get those reviews starting to go up in your favor. So appreciate the support, brother. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to look me up. Thanks, man.